All right, everybody, welcome back to Behind the Lens. This is your boy. This is your host. You already know this is Zoe. And listen, I am excited because today I have my brother and my friend, none other than the Richard Shaw Jr. with me. What's going on, man? How are you?
I am fantastic, man. How are you, man?
I'm great. I'm happy to have you on today, man.
It's an honor to be on, man. Thank you for having me.
Yes, sir. Definitely. And I'm loving that shirt. Believe again.
Yes, sir.
So can you just real quick, can you tell us just a little bit about that and what that means?
You know, it means so many different things to me, honestly, Lorenzo. But I'll tell you the truncated version is that, you know, everything that you desire, everything that you want manifested, all your goals, all your dreams, it starts with believing. You know, I tell people that, you know, there's so much power in the belief system. You know, you'll never pursue what you don't believe, and you'll never have what you don't pursue. So it all starts and originates with your belief system. If you believe you can actually accomplish something, your goals, your dreams, your purpose, it will happen.
Facts. And I'm a witness to that. And,
yes.
And just in the short period of time that I've known you, I know that you're a definite testament to that. Just seeing your life and how it's transformed in the two years I've known you.
Yeah.
Even before that, I mean, you've had quite a journey. Just getting to know you and following you. So for you that don't know, Richard is an amazing musician, saxophonist, but that's not all he plays, but we'll get into that a little later. But amazing saxophonist. And when they say your gift will make room for you, Richard is a testament to that. Because you do this full time, is that correct?
Yeah.
How long did it take you to get to that point?
So 2019, August was my last day in corporate America. I walked away in 2019, September 1st was my journey of really walking in my purpose and my calling full time. And I've never looked back. Business was better in 2020 than it was in 2019. So in the midst of a pandemic, my business just exploded, and then it just continued to explode. So I'm very grateful to God for that.
Yeah, that's amazing. And because of what you do, I truly believe, because you do more than just play, you give hope. And like you win. So if you never seen Richard or heard him play, he plays with so much passion and just like you can feel it. And you were so needed during that time, during the pandemic, because you're dealing with so many people that are a lot of people losing their minds. You know, they're stuck at home. This is a new way of life that they didn't expect, that they didn't want, you know? So I truly believe a great deal of that, of you blowing up like that in 2020, is because of you being that light, you know, you being that hope for that person. You know,
right.
And one thing that I do see you highlighting that you impact, what is it, 6 million lives?
Yes.
Okay, so, right.
Yes, yes. So this year we're right at like 7.1 million now for this year alone.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
That's amazing. So did you ever see yourself, like, just looking back on your life, did you ever see yourself doing this?
Honestly, Lorenzo, I've always had a desire to play the saxophone, but I didn't see myself here. And let me explain that. Mm-hmm. Growing up, I was very, extremely afraid of people. I would not talk to anyone. Like, if you put me in front of a crowd, I would probably die. I would literally faint and pass out. I was just that type. I was just nervous. I was shy. I couldn't speak to people. Public speaking, my biggest fear. Mm-hmm. So to stand in front of people playing the sax, you know, I could see myself playing the sax, maybe behind the scenes or recording music, but never in front of an audience, because that was one of my biggest fears. So honestly, I did not see myself doing what I'm doing today, but I know today I was purposed to do because there's other people that were in my same shoes, doubting themselves, needing to believe again in themselves to really accomplish their goals and dreams. And for me to be able to be a beacon of light to let them know, no, I was there. This is where I was. I came out of it. If I can do it, I promise you, you can do it.
That's amazing, man. And so through your period, through your journey, whenever you were finding in yourself and believing in yourself again, you came up with a tune, which is called Believe Again. And I must say, that's one of the things that I do listen to every now and then, just to kind of give me a pick me up. Because so we're both musicians here. I play keyboard. I started off on the drums, but saxophone, that's one of those things I've always wanted to like learn. So like one day before I leave here, I will learn. But Believe Again, that song truly do help me. And that's wow. So thank you for all that you do.
Absolutely.
And I know in this purpose walk, this journey that we're taking, is not always easy. Can you just take us behind the lens of your life and just kind of, you know, what we don't see from your social media and just seeing you perform? What, take us behind the lens of you.
So behind the lens of Richard, I grew up in a two-parent household. I have two siblings. They're older than I. And, you know, I don't take my life for granted because my mom, I've actually had a brother, but he passed away in my mother's womb and he didn't make it. He would have been my only brother that I had, but he passed away in my mother's womb. And of course, I was born and everybody was like, you know, Trezetta, that's my mom's name, you know, you're 42, you're too old to be having children. And the doctor already told her, you cannot have children, you're 42, you need to stop. And I was kind of like that miracle baby because they weren't expecting me to be born because she was on birth control, as well as the doctors already said, you wouldn't have any more children. So, you know, growing up in the household where my father was always working, I didn't spend a lot of time with my father. Because he was busy providing, making sure we had a household. My mom, she was a stay-at-home mom. So she didn't do a lot of work, but she was big in entrepreneurship. I think that's where I got that entrepreneurship bug, because she could sell you anything. I tell people the funny story. My mom used to sell dirt and she made thousands of dollars. I'm not kidding you, selling dirt. How she did it, I don't know.
Well, what was special about the dirt?
You know, it was this particular dirt that, you know, if you use this dirt, it will help your plants grow faster. I believe it was a network marketing company, if I'm not mistaken. But she was able to earn thousands of dollars selling something, you know, I felt like you can get in the backyard. But, you know, so I grew up in this household. My mom was a vocalist. My dad is a musician. My sister sings. We had a household that was very musically inclined, so to speak. And I just had this desire. You know, I went to a Boy Scout camp. I was in Boy Scouts at 10 years old. I was listening to the radio and I overheard this sax player. Come to find out, it was Kenny G. And I was just like, wow, I want to do this. And then fast forward 2 years later, I met another musician that played sax in my elementary school. His name was Richard. Coincidence. So here it is. I fell in love with the sound of the sax. I actually visually saw someone playing the sax, performing in front of a crowd. And I was just like, I want to play the sax. And that's really how the journey began. It started initially with my mind. And then it became a physical physical manifestation when my mom actually bought the saxophone and I began to play. And, you know, fast forward to here, you know, I'm here with the Believe Again mission.
It's a powerful mission. So for those of you who don't know or that aren't really familiar with Richard Shaw Jr.'s brand and Vice Productions brand, I've had the opportunity to collaborate with him on a couple of projects. And I can truly say the projects are more than just projects. It's always heartfelt. It's always something attached to it with everything. The first thing we've done together was actually a music. It was a collective of music videos, but it was more of a tribute project in Sarasota, Florida. You want to talk about that a little bit?
Absolutely. So for those of you, I initially met Lorenzo in South Carolina. He sent me a couple of video clips as a teaser, and I immediately fell in love with his work. I was like, what? Like, we never had a conversation. He just sent me some video clips of my band and I, and I was just like, wow, like, this is, yeah. So I always had him in mind to do some more work, but we landed this deal with a special client in Sarasota, Florida. And when I tell you that project was, it was more than playing the sax. It was more than video capturing and, you know, the whole production. It was ministry, guys.
Yeah.
Like, I still get text from this day from this client that says, Richard, thank you for what you and your team did. I mean, Lorenzo, he was able to capture every significant moment, and we had millions of them. And it was so many of them. So for him to be able to capture, and it's a truncated version, to put every powerful moment within minutes, that's skill, that's anointing, that's expertise. Like, Lorenzo, I mean, that right there, it was just like, wow. And that's when I knew that Lorenzo not only had a skill, but he has really anointing for what he does, because there's no way you can put millions of powerful moments and capture into just a few minutes and really be able to tell that story of what we experienced as a unit. So, you know, big shout out to Lorenzo. Just amazing.
All glory to God, man. Like you said, this is your purpose journey. This is my purpose journey as well, you know. And it's just so amazing to see we're both on our own journeys, but when God can put us together for a greater cause, and like, that's just beautiful to see.
Yeah. And a lot of people can't do that. You know, you have these egos, but to be able to work together, Tier was phenomenal with the direction, creative director of the project, giving Lorenzo instructions. And then, you know, me, we were kind of like, hey, whatever you tell us to do, we're going to follow it, make it happen. And then we were able to come together without egos. But the whole goal was to really ensure that our client had a powerful product at the end of the day that she can use for the rest of her life and continue to be blessed. Legacy tribute. That's what it was.
Legacy tribute. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
That's probably one of my favorite out of all of the projects I've been on. That's probably
my
favorite, like, just because of the impact. Yeah. So, yeah. When you were, you know, giving your introduction, your background, you mentioned Kenny G. So I'm a big Kenny G fan myself. Like, growing up in a small community, we had the community center, and whenever anybody had any kind of event, wedding, birthday celebration, Kenny G was the dinner music.
Yeah.
So like, exactly. I can hum pretty much all of his songs because he's amazing. He's the GOAT. And you got to meet him recently, right?
Yes. I got to meet him in Atlanta. He came down to perform. He had a concert, and it was incredible. He did a phenomenal job. I took notes. I was so busy taking notes while he was performing. I was like, okay, I see how he's doing that. I see how he's moving. I see the intro. And for me, it was truly an experience to watch and to really, take on the knowledge, all the years of his performances, and to be able to see it in the hour and a half was just, and it was incredible.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
How was the conversation like with him?
Well, it was brief. I basically told him, I'm a huge fan of yours, and I've listened to just about every song he's in. And out, I can remember growing up practicing the sax, and I hear a riff that he would play, and I'm like, okay, let me see if I can do this, and I'll try to play that riff, and I'm like, man, I can't do it. It's so hard, man. I tried to do it. And then over a period of time, I began to be able to play and do some of his riffs. And so that was very exciting because it's like, okay, I still have some of his riffs in my head that I'm playing today that I learned from him. So to be able to, speak with him very briefly, it was powerful. Yeah.
Awesome. Awesome. So one of the songs that I like, one of my favorite songs by him, I can't remember the name of it, but it goes like dun 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 dun. And then when he goes into like his solo part, he does like a lot of like jumping up and down, and I can't. Does it sound familiar?
I'm trying to recall the melody. I know it's not Silhouette, that's not Songbird, and that's not Wedding Song.
If I find it, I'm gonna send it to you. Cause
Okay.
I hear it so clearly in my head, but I can't. But what he does on the sax is, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-
Okay, I think I know I think you're talking about Silhouette or Songbird.
It's one of the two.
What is that?
Yeah. So, yeah, I love Kenny G. But,
yeah, man.
So you, over the last few years, you've pretty much created a brand with your name.
Mm-hmm.
How did the Richard Shaw Jr. brand become the brand? And this is a two-part question. Second part, how do you separate the brand from the person, or is it all in one?
That's a great question. So the brand, even though my name is there, it's bigger than Richard Shaw Jr. So Richard Shaw Jr. is just my name, right? But the brand is really positively impacting the lives of over a billion people through music and believing again. So the true brand is really the mission and the vision in my eyes.
Okay.
I'm just a conduit in which that vision and that mission is coming through. And with the help of people like yourself, the help of people who really believe in the goals and the dreams, you know, that's really, for me, really the brand. I want that to be ahead of my name. You know, I'm just blessed to be a vessel, but it's not about me. It's really about that whole Believe Again mission. And really, you know, I'll share this with you, Lorenzo. For the longest, I was confused on when people would ask me, what style of music do you play? You know, and I would be like so confused, and you know, I would just name some stuff. It was just recently, 2 days ago, Lorenzo.
Wow.
I was struggling with this again. And God gave me peace. This is what he shared with me. He said, Richard, you're not a genre. Stop focusing on the genre of music.
That's good.
He said, Richard, your genre of music is bridge. And I was like, bridge? What does that have to do with anything? He said, you're a bridge from heaven to earth.
Ooh, that's not even what I was thinking. That's good.
And I was like, he said, bridge. B, your music is beautiful. Mm. R, your music is rich. I, your music is intellectual. He said, D, your music is desirable. G, your music is godlike. And E, you stand for excellence. Your music is excellence. He said, you're the bridge from heaven to earth. So that's why it's important for you to really be in tune with me. Mm. And I was like, wow, okay, God, I accepted it. That's what he gave me. But for the longest, I could not tell. I was stuck in jazz, or I played contemporary, or I played gospel, or I played this. He said, no, you're different. You're a bridge.
That's powerful.
And it totally blew me away. I was like, God, I accept that.
That's powerful. And when you said bridge, my mind automatically went to like just bridging the gap, because I mean, just thinking among genres, you play pretty much any genre of music. So like you're bridging the gap between, you can, it doesn't matter what you play, somebody can find and see God through what you play. So that's powerful.
Yeah, that's good, man.
Wow. So with you pursuing purpose and with you doing what you're doing, you're busy all the time. So tell me, how do you separate that from like time with your family and you know, friends?
That's a great question. So really, I have to be intentional. That's what it really boils down to. And I don't say that from a cliche perspective. I say that more of a transparency perspective, because I haven't always been intentional with really garnering and spending time with my family and making sure, okay, Richard, you can't practice 4 to 5 hours like you used to when you were in your single life. You could practice 8 hours a day and it's cool. But when you have a family, you know, my son, my daughter, my wife, they spell love T-I-M-E. And if I'm not spending T-I-M-E with them, they're feeling like I H-A-T-E them, right? I don't like them or I hate them. And that's not the case. So I have to really be nowadays intentional with that time with them, as well as time for myself.
Yeah.
You know, one of the things I learned over the last 2 years is really that self-care. I can only give what I have. And if I'm depleted, I can't give. So making sure I have self-care time is really important to me, as well as family time and times with friends. So really, honestly, it has to be, you know, the key to that was just being intentional now, making sure that I write it in the schedule, write it in the calendar. Hey, listen, this is the time for them. Don't forget this. You can't overdo this.
Right. And that's something that I had to learn myself, and still, you know, we're all still growing, still learning. But one thing, like touching on the self-care piece, I don't want to give out your business or nothing, but just from working with you in the past, I've noticed it's a particular day where it's pretty much your day, your self-care day. And that's something that I've, you know, taken of custom to, you know, like I set aside this one day where even if it's just doing absolutely nothing, that's, you know, my self-care day, you know, doing what I need to do, because I know how it feels to work from a depleted place and to give from a depleted place. And ultimately you're killing yourself.
Yeah. You know,
you want to be that person for everybody, but you got to be there for yourself first. Because ultimately, how you are can impact what you give people. But our time is running out, but I just wanted to, I'm glad that I had you on this call, man. I'm glad that we're having this conversation. You have a lot of big things coming up, and specifically, you've done some traveling, but you are about to go to South Dakota. Tell us about that.
Yeah, man. Very, very exciting information. I'm traveling to Sioux Falls, South Dakota, and I'm playing for Sioux Falls University. So I'm literally going to be their live entertainment for 3 days. It's their homecoming, and they have different events. You know, I'll be performing at their tailgating, they have a couple events for just the presidents and staff. They have a president's picnic and just all these different things that's taking place over a series of 3 days. And I'm the only live entertainment. And I'm really honored to, you know, go out there and do my best to do an amazing job so I could continue to grow and expand. You know, I tell people I'm not just a Georgia musician, even though a lot of engagements are here. I travel, and I look forward to bringing other people with me. So be on standby as I continue to grow. Lorenzo, you gonna be going overseas and doing some other stuff with me, man.
Yes, sir. I'm always ready.
Yes, always ready.
But it has been an absolute pleasure having you on, my brother. Real quick before we go, can you tell our listeners and viewers how we can reach out to you, get in contact, book you?
Sure. You can reach out my website, which is www.richardshawjr.com. Simply my name, www.richardshawjr.com. And you can also reach out via Instagram. My Instagram is Richard Shaw Jr., as well as Facebook, Richard Shaw Jr. And I'm on LinkedIn, YouTube. All of that is under Richard Shaw Jr.
Awesome, man. So any last things you would like to say? So something that I do is Wednesday Wisdom. And with that, you know, just giving something to encourage the viewers, listeners, just to get them through their day.
Good stuff, man. Well, I'll give you the quote that I always quote, and that's simply, your obedience today is someone else's promise tomorrow. Bad. So critical.
Yeah, that's good. Well, my brother, I appreciate you again, and thank you.
Thank you, Lorenzo. I appreciate you even more, man. Thanks for having me.